Hello everybody, good morning, good afternoon if you're watching the video after the morning. So this video was actually from yesterday, but this video that I'm showing you guys is actually the greatest video that I got to see that has combined of what happened yesterday, the events. So the first caravan came in aggressive, and I thought it was aggressive. No, man, this is the second caravan, and this one's aggressive. Check this one out, guys. So just to translate what it says right there at the bottom, this is actually a Guatemalan news station that got the coverage of what happened yesterday, January 20th, 2020. Title reads, "Migrants Clash with the Mexican National Guard." They have confrontations, a little bit of tussles, and they even get gas thrown at them. So we're going to see all that in this video.
Aprovechando que durante esta época del año, el cauce del río Suchiate disminuye considerablemente, los integrantes de la caravana 2020 aprovecharon para cruzar de forma masiva y se encaminaron rápidamente a la orilla del lado mexicano. Sin embargo, ya eran esperados por miembros de la Guardia Nacional Mexicana que estaban instalados a la orilla del Suchiate.
All right, so the journalist just said that each year around this time, the Rio Suchiate, the tide goes down. So about this time, everyone starts crossing. Everyone knows that it's like the right time to cross. So knowing that, they did. But in a massive form, like every other caravan, right? They did so with the intention to cross into the Mexican side and do what any other caravan has done best. Just go straight up, north. But this time, the National Guard was waiting for them. So let's see how good did they do, or let's see how bad did they do. Let's see what's up. As you can see, it is a bunch of people. It's probably like in the 500 to 1,000 people.
Se toparon con la barrera formada por la Guardia Nacional, no dudaron en abalanzarse sobre ellos para cruzar a la fuerza. Los agentes mexicanos de inmediato lanzaron gas lacrimógeno, pero esto no disuadió a los migrantes, quienes respondieron tomando piedras del río y comenzaron a lanzárselas a las fuerzas de seguridad mexicana.
All right, so it says here that once the migrants had reached the Mexican soil, they did not doubt for a second to go head on with the National Guard. Obviously, because their intentions are to cross, to get across, get into Mexico, and continue their journey north. But this time it kind of failed, because the National Guard was waiting for them, and they started throwing gas at them. But guess what? Like I said, if the first caravan looked aggressive, well, check this one out. This one was way more aggressive.
Haciéndolas retroceder hasta el poblado aledaño a la orilla del río, donde se produjo un fuerte enfrentamiento.
All right, so to everyone that's pro migration, let me remind you that yes, it is, in some states, in some countries, it's acceptable, it's passable, it's legal. But recently, AMLO has said that they cannot use Mexico as a bridge anymore to cross to United States. People trying to go to United States have to stay in Mexico, you know what I mean? Even before the first caravan came out, AMLO said perfectly, you know what? We're allowing everyone to come into Mexico, to stay in Mexico, get jobs here in Mexico. South side only. You know what I mean? South side only. No gang related. But check out how this confrontation just, and we weren't even there. This is a camera. We haven't even heard of the people that got thrown rocks at, the National Guard. I mean, we haven't heard of the people injured. So just check this one out. This is crazy.
Lo accidentado del terreno de la ribera del río, junto con las piedras y el gas lacrimógeno, provocó que migrantes y soldados resbalaran y cayeran en varias ocasiones. Los cientos de hondureños trataban de encontrar un punto de ingreso a México, pero la Guardia Nacional le cerraba todos los espacios. Después de más de media hora de enfrentamientos y correteos, la Guardia Nacional retomó el control de la ribera del Suchate y los hondureños fueron replegados al afluente con dirección a Guatemala. Muy pocos lograron cruzar y se internaron en suelo mexicano.